Till now, I have walked you through installing pixels with the help of Google Tag Manager, setting up standard events, and finally setting up custom events. You can access those videos by clicking on the I button. In this video, I'll explain everything about domain verification. In the next one, how to set up aggregated events. Well, don't worry if you didn't understand anything. I'll obviously explain what that is. So, the iOS 14 update, as we all know, has affected how Facebook receives and processes conversion events from Facebook tools such as the Facebook Pixel. To address these changes, Facebook will request permission through Apple's App Tracking Transparency Framework to measure conversion events occurring on any of the iOS 14 devices. As more people opt out of tracking on iOS 14 devices, ads personalization and performance reporting will be limited for both app as well as web conversion events. A key impact of this change is that you will be limited to use only 8 conversion events per domain for optimization as well as reporting. Also, when you create an ad set, you can only choose one of the 8 designated conversion events to optimize for. Domain verification establishes which business manager account has the authority to configure and prioritize the 8 available conversion events for a given domain. Domain verification also allows you to manage editing permissions over your links and content in order to help prevent misuse of your domain. This includes both organic and paid content. Managing your ad link editing permissions also helps ensure that only trusted employees and partners represent your brand. Once you have verified your domain, you can assign specific pages editing permissions for your ads. Pages associated with your business manager that do not have editing permissions won't be able to make changes to your ads. In short, you need this in order to combat the iOS 14 update. Now, how to do so? Go to your ads manager or business manager or wherever you are. Click on this hamburger menu and then go to the business settings. Locate brand safety in the left panel and then click on domain, which will bring you to this screen. And then click on add. Then type the URL of your website and click add again. Now there are 3 options available for you to verify your domain. Facebook has already made a simple video on how to do the same using all the 3. I'm going to put the link of this video in the description below and you can check that out and you can do it. The easiest one is DNS TXT record, according to me. And you can use whichever you want. If you have a webmaster, just forward it to him, or you can just go through the video I just mentioned and you can verify the domain all by yourself. It's not rocket science, it's pretty easy. After you have done that, you will see the verified written next to your domain name. Also, then you can assign partners, which means you can give access to another business manager, like if you want to share the access with an agency. Then you can associate a page to this domain by clicking on the ad sets. And this is how, my dear friend, we verify your domain. I guess we did it in less than 3 minutes. Seems cool. In the next video, we'll talk about setting up those aggregated events that I talked about in the start of this video. Also, this video was a part of the course on how to run the Facebook ads, and you can access the full course over here. Until next time, bye-bye.